Howdy folks, and welcome back to this Let's Play of Hearts of Iron number 4. My name is Sanilis, and we're going to be loading the American, should be focusing on the Republican Americans, as opposed to Democratic Americans, ruling the USA during the Second World War period. So the Second World War period ruled by, in this instance, the Republican United States. All right, so if I look at this unit here, these units here are part of a division. Am I still preparing? Okay. I thought I had prepared already. Do you want to do anything with that war goal? I probably could do. So I think it's a nice idea to basically, at the start of this episode, really, yeah, just say, bye, guys, really, we're going to war with you. Yeah. Go. I'm going to execute that plan. So we're at war, guys. We're at war. The US has declared war. Now what kind of effect will that have on the world theater? It looks like we're basically getting a 4% declaration of war in terms of the world tension. We're increasing it by 4%, it looks like. Ooh, Venezuela joins the Axis. Interesting. Does that now mean I'm at war with the Axis? Yeah, you can do that. Ooh, interesting. They invite us to become part of the Allies. Now, I'm quite inclined to say no. Yeah, I'm willing to sign a non-aggression pact with you, that's fine. I'm quite willing to do that. Let's get that clock running again. In terms of actual research, we still got a number of days in terms of research to do. War bonds, they are still on the table. I'm letting the US or Britain move troops through our territory. Now, am I at war with them? I don't think I am. I'm guaranteeing the independence of lots of nations, as you can see. Interesting. Venezuela. Okay, so who am I at war with? That is, in this instance, Venezuela itself. Aggression pact, yes. Aggression pact again. British Malaysia. Luxembourg wants to move troops to our territory. Interesting. Poland. Poland doesn't exist as far as I can see, but okay. Non-aggression pact. Australia wants to move troops to our territory again. Belgium wants to move troops to our territory. So if I look back at our war here. Who else is this party here? That is Croatia. We're at war with Croatia. Interesting. This here's Hungary. Croatia and Hungary have joined the war. Yeah, you can move troops through our territory. I'm okay with that. Doesn't mean, of course, I'm not going to be aggressive towards you. Okay, look at that. They're not really well organized. That's really their main problem at the moment. China. Okay, bear with me one second. Let's have a look at China. So this is this party here, is it not? Yeah. If I look at that state of China here, they are non-aligned. Whereas these guys here are communist. And of course, they got lots more communist parties there. these guys are at war with Japan and so forth. I'm gonna decline that for the moment.
Let them have it!
I'm basically taking ownership of different territory there.
Call it. Listen up.
Not sure where you call that retreating. Okay.
Move out. Boom, boom, boom.
Let's have a look at all these other requests. Luxembourg. Does Luxembourg still exist? Yeah, I'm quite happy to sign a non-aggression pact with you for the moment. Move troops through our territory. Send to Norway. I'm not gonna sign a non-aggression pact with you guys. Send with you guys. Send with you guys. Yeah, so, yeah, no, not gonna happen.
Ready, sir!
Am I in ownership of any of these ports here? No. At least I don't think so. Puerto Rico? No.
Borders.
I am in ownership of that territory there, which is already closer to there. So I'm just going to move those bits over there. So look, that at the moment is a naval base level 3. So I might want to upgrade that. The higher level naval base. Earhart wants to enlist an American, mobilize. Okay, interesting. Good. So let's upgrade our port facilities. Facilities there. As American mobilizes for war, we have received an unusual request from Amelia Earhart, the famous aviator who successfully circumnavigated the globe not long ago, wishing to enlist in the Army Air Corps as a fighter pilot. She's demonstrated considerable skill in mock dogfights, but there are many within the military establishment who frown on the idea of having a woman flying combat missions. Should we make an exception in her case or let her join? Now, political power we're going to lose. 10. Well, okay, I'm willing to accept that. As long as, of course, we don't have massive casualties because of that. Italy. So we're at war with Italy as well now. Interesting. That raises a bit of a question as to what I want to do with all my naval power. Let's actually have a look at my naval power as it stands at the moment. So this one here has got no commander, as you can see. The USS Naval Group here. Let's have a look at these other ones here. West Coast. I'm going to start patrolling here, really. So that one is going to go towards the North Pacific. I'm going to change its anchor point here as well. Be this location here. So let's do that again. I'm going to set this to search and destroy. These two regions based out of Oregon. Naval base. I probably want to upgrade that naval base, so let's have a look at doing that. Alright, perfect, done. I've got more units. damage like that. West Coast, this one is also an interesting one here to have. Let's have a look at all these units here. It's two new ones. I can actually maybe... drag that one into there. That one's already got a lot of them, as you can see. Needs a bit of extra support, I would say. Put all of them in there. None of these spare apples, unfortunately. I'm going to put that one in the top one. This one is the Mid-Atlantic one, isn't it? East Coast. I still have a submarine fleet group here that I can actually use to, let's say I want to basically blockade what I'm doing here at the moment. So at the moment they're based in Norfolk. I'm going to move this one down here, I think. I'm going to base them down there. First off, base them down there, and then we're actually going to do a convoy raiding here in this territory here. Bear with me 1 second. Apologies for the slight interruption. We're back. Probably in a slightly different position on screen, but that's just to be expected. We're slightly interrupted here on my own premise. Anyways, our invasion of Venezuela is still progressing. We are actually attacking here at their capital city. I'm gonna try to basically get some extra troops in here. Really, what I wanted to have seen happening is actually us taking that capital city straight away, Caracas.
Orders.
Let's change some of these orders slightly.
Attention.
Oh, that would be nice as well.
Ready to move.
Could still aim for that. Get my hands on that port city at least, and can actually get some reinforcements in there, which would be really, really helpful. Alright, let's have a look what else is happening here. Okay, they're attacking us. They're going to absolutely fail at that. That's okay. Doing too well here, it looks like. We do have planes operating over here. Let's have a look at the other airfield bits. So these are standing by at the moment. I'm going to send them out here to actually do supporting all of our troops. Same with this one here, it's a naval bomber actually. I'm going to send that one out here to do naval strikes and port strikes. Well, not, let's not do the port strikes, but at least the naval strikes. Non-aggression pact with the British Malaya. Nope, I'm going to refuse that for the moment. South Africa, I can do something with you. Ooh. Let's have a look at these guys. Are they actually... Yeah, let's do that for the aggression. Yeah, I can do that. Alright, let's have a look at these guys here. Are they willing to speak to me? Should I speak to me on diplomacy terms? I can't create affection yet because our relationship is the wrong way. Likely to accept democratic pressure. Okay. That's good at least.
Let's go!
No defensive effort going on here, and it looks like we're actually winning this. Which is good. 90%. Good. Once I've actually got that up and running, we'll be able to do far better. Yes. Aye. Aye. Of course, happy to have more troops there than I
keep on moving.
Would. Am I losing troops here?
Ready, sir.
It does look like it, doesn't it? Assigned to it, interesting. Why did I not assign to
it? Listen up! Orders! Keep on moving!
Yeah, let's go back into there.
Keep on moving!
That's not good. I should have straight away gone for taking over one of their port cities. At least I would have basically had a better chance then.
Yes, sir.
Let's maybe change these orders here. Actually, say we're going to do an invasion from there into here. Once I'm on land, it'll be far, far easier for us to do this. Yugoslavia have capitulated. Okay.
Taking aim!
Not good losing troops like that, but okay. That's of course what happens in a war. You really start doing some production of those, I would say. So Argentina, what party are they supporting now? Argentina. Hold on. Argentina. Issues of war bonds is progressing nicely. looks like I'll be doing that shortly. There we go, let's pause that. Let's look at the details of that. So as you can see, that now basically frees up quite a few more troops. And I can choose which of these I'm going to go for. National Spirit, Wartime Industry, which grants civilian to military factory conversion. Reserve Company. Decryption Research, Encryption Research. Let's go for this one. Yeah, one day until we basically finish the research on that new fighter there. And we should see also an increase, of course, in our production. Perfect. So we're in 1940 now, so we can basically go down this route here as well. I can research the Wildcat version of this. I can also research this plane here. Alright, we are still building an outdated plane here, it looks like. I'm going to upgrade this to the new version, which is the 502. Find my way through from there, which is probably what I should have done in the first instance when I set my orders. Make sure I set them such that I can actually get my supplies and reinforcements in.
Ready, sir!
Alright, this guy has got orders, so perfect. Let's have another look at some of our ships here on the east coast. This is just one submarine. Okay, I'm gonna leave that as is. This guy here is based in California at the moment. I'm gonna set this to be a search and destroy. These orders here. So I'm gonna look at some of our ships here. This one's still at anchor on the west coast. Again in California. Alright, I'll be able to use that unit shortly. Alright, where else? Alright, I got units moving through here already. Where's Hawaii? Hawaii should be really over here. I'm gonna rebase this unit to the location here. And I'll do a search and destroy of that region there. So as you can see at the moment, it's got already three carriers assigned to it, so that's a good start. Where else have we got units at anchor still? This is over here still. It's at the Panama Canal. Again, I can actually have them join the search and destroy over here. To go for that one. Right, so yeah, I probably screwed up a little bit with that original invasion, but yeah, it happens. Let's see what we can do to basically alleviate some of our other issues here. Not enough manpower or equipment to train one of these divisions. Interesting. Now I've got the manpower here, but I don't have the equipment at the moment. Now over here, it seems to be the opposite story. This is infantry divisions. Let's just double check what it is that we got in there. Back, I'll edit this. Should I add something to here? Probably. I want to add maybe some of my hospitals, field hospitals as well. Let's go recon to there. And I can save this as an updated design. Perfect. So that actually should make my units more durable. Missing equipment, motorized. Okay. Let's move these up in the chain. So as you can see, I need a fair number of these. Thank you. Anyways. The Lear's course is to learn from our mistakes. And yeah. Hopefully this invasion of the port city should be seen as a learning exercise. Now, what are we going to name this? Let's call this the Americas Forever. All right. Invited them to become a faction member. So the dawn of Americas Forever. Okay, it's been theorized that democracies do not go to war with each other, but this, okay. Okay. Same faction as each other. I can invite certain parties, of course, to my faction if I wanted to. Invite to faction is not possible because opinion of the United States, world tension. Invite any of these at the moment, it looks like. So be it. Are any of the other islands here? See, there's individual countries? Not really. There is, of course, a whole bunch of them here. Seem to work for any of these, unfortunately. Again, it's basically the relationships that are the issue, it looks like. Some of them are more negative than others, but okay. I can invite to faction the Philippines. Ah! Okay, that makes sense. See, at the moment there is really, really limited armies here in the Philippines. I need to change that at some point in the future, but for the moment being, let's just leave that as is. And I guess at this point we should really basically be calling it a day. Yeah, we've gotten to a nice point. So let's call it a day, and of course carry on with this in the next episode. In the meantime, thanks again for joining me. Hope you enjoyed it, and in the meantime, take care. Bye-bye.